The Assembly will hear an address by His Excellency Ahmed Abdallah Sambi, President of the Union of Comoros. I request protocol to escort His Excellency.
The Assembly will hear an address by His Excellency Ahmed Abdallah Sambi, President of the Union of Comoros. I request protocol to escort His Excellency.
On behalf of the General Assembly, I have the honor to welcome to the United Nations His Excellency Ahmed Abdallah Sambi, President of the Union of the Comoros, and to invite him to address the Assembly.
General Assembly, I have the honor to welcome to the United Nations His Excellency Ahmed Abdallah Sambi, President of the Union of the Comoros, and to invite him to address the Assembly.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على محمد وآل محمد Excellence Monsieur le Président de l'Assemblée Générale Excellence Mesdames et Messieurs les chefs d'État et de gouvernement Excellence Monsieur le Secrétaire Général Honorable
Once again, this year, I should like to devote most of my statement to the important matter of the Comorian island of Mayotte. This is a dispute between us and France for over three decades. It is our hope that there will be greater understanding on the part of this August Assembly on this matter and more active solidarity.
Et d'une solidarité agissante
It is my belief that the future of my country, the Union of Comoros, depends on peace and stability. But there can be no lasting stability in my country unless there is a final solution to this problem. Accordingly, once again this year, we have requested inclusion on the agenda of the 65th session of the General Assembly, an item entitled The Comorian Island of
Mayotte.
I would like to take this opportunity of extending the deep thanks of the people of Comoros for invaluable and unwavering support provided on this matter by the African Union, the Arab League, and the Organization of the Islamic Conference.
L'Union Africaine, la Ligue des États Arabes,
Mr. President, I would like to begin by recalling that, pursuant to recommendations of the United Nations, the highest authorities of France themselves stated that the Comoros should accede to independence with borders inviolate. And so the former president of France, Valéry Giscard d'Estaing, said, inter alia, the Comoros are one, have always been one, and it is natural that their future will be as one.
Ont toujours été une unité et il est naturel que leur sort soit un sort
I would also like to recall today some resolutions adopted here at the United Nations. I find it necessary and timely to recall these resolutions. To confirm the legitimacy of the Comorian claim to the island of Mayotte.
De la revendication comorienne de cette
île. First of all, refer to General Assembly Resolution 1514 of the 15th session, dated 14 December 1960, on the granting of independence to colonial countries and peoples. It guarantees the national unity and the territorial integrity of those countries,
l'unité nationale et l'intégrité territoriale d'un pays
est incompatible avec les vues et les principes de la Charte des Nations Unies.
International jurisprudence fully recognizes this principle of the indivisibility of colonial entities. In a decision handed down on 11 September 1980, regarding a dispute between Honduras and El Salvador, the International Court in The Hague proclaimed that le Honduras, El Salvador, la Cour internationale de la Haye, de la Haye proclame que le principe de l'impossibilité de frontières coloniales est un principe